Hello, my name is Ali Çimen. I am the head of global medical affairs within GSK. Before joining pharmaceutical industry, I was a treating physician nearly for 10 years. Peter, I know that you were also a practicing physician until very recently. Could you please introduce yourself briefly?
Sure. So I'm Peter Barth, and I graduated hematology oncology fellowship at Brown University in 2018, and then stayed on at Brown to run the multiple myeloma clinic there and also treat other hematologic disorders. And then in 2023, I moved over to GSK, where I joined the oncology clinical development group.
Thank you, Peter. As a physician and also a researcher, what do you think has changed in the recent years when it comes to cancer research?
We've gone into more of a phase of personalized medicine and using some of the innovative technologies that are out there now. We can predict that what patients are going to respond well, what the potential side effects may be for patients, and how we can best manage that balance of risk and benefit.
When you think about those innovative technologies like artificial intelligence, machine learning, how are they impacting our clinical trials?
I think one of the ways that this has been really impactful for us in trial design is being able to take a step back and say, okay, well, we have these different trials that we've run, and we've got so many thousands and hundreds of thousands of data points that we're obtaining from these clinical trials. And it's not really possible for a clinician or for, you know, one person to be able to understand what are the trends in an entire program. And so being able to take a step back and look at the bigger picture and input this data to determine, well, you know, is there a signal that we should be looking out for?
Yes, I think we can confidently say that GSK is taking this very seriously. I think we are also moving towards more patient-centered approaches, not only while treating cancer patients, but also doing the research. So how are you and your colleagues collecting and incorporating those patient insights in our clinical trials?
So when we're talking to patient representatives and patient organizations, we're really talking about three different buckets where it would impact clinical trial design. The first is simply inclusion-exclusion criteria. Where are there patients that we could really include in the trial, and where should we change our criteria so that we're not excluding patients unnecessarily? The second bucket would be really an informed consent. And so making sure that our informed consent forms are understandable to patients. The third would be in the actual trial conduct, how do we make this simpler for them? So really hearing from the patients, you know, what are the changes or what were the pain points? It's been great to be able to collaborate with patient advocates and patients to really talk through, okay, what bothers you about these trials? What are the things that don't make sense to you?
We have identified many times some very easy to fix, simple edits that we can make in the protocols, which were significantly increasing the probability of success and ease of those, you know, protocols while they are being executed. When you think about all the progress that we made in cancer research arena, so what is your future vision? What should we be expecting maybe in the next 10 years or so?
We're doing a great job with efficacy. And now we need to look at making sure that patients have both quality of life and quantity of life.
Thank you, Peter. It was a very, very good and inspiring conversation. And as we reflect on the progress we made in the last couple of decades for cancer research, I think as GSK, we are confident that one day cancer will be eliminated from our lives. But until then, we'll continue to, you know, focus on this while we continue to put more years in patients' lives. We are also working hard to put more life in patients' years. And once again, thank you, Peter.